In the world of office politics, leaders often need to rely on someone they can trust. What are the critical criteria for a good confidant, according to the CEO of a consulting giant, the former head of US Homeland Security, a soccer legend, and the boss of a world-famous brand?
You feel very lonely at the top of the organization. And that's a bit the curse of the CEO. You're on your own. And so it's extremely important, like for any person on the planet, that you have someone you can call, you trust, and you can openly share your challenges or your questions. What was very important for me is to find someone, first, who's not going to judge me. Second, we'll never provide answers, but ask the good questions.
No leader, no matter how brilliant, has a monopoly on good ideas. And I think leaders who only have sycophants around them are leaders who are going to be much less effective and indeed will probably fail. I rely heavily on my chief of staff, deputy chiefs of staff. I've always used that as a good model that works for me. My chief of staff is someone who typically their office is right next to mine. We meet first thing in the morning. We converse at the end of the day. Next to the chief of staff, perhaps most key, the person who does communications for you.
What makes for a good confidant? I think the word confident means confidence. And I think you have to have confidence in the judgment of the other person and that they are being transparent and are telling you what they think. One of the people that I was most impressed in my career was the ex-chairman of McDonald's. He basically built up the company called Fred Turner. And he said that the one single thing that I most had to pay attention to was having people tell me the truth, not being afraid of telling me the truth. And a confidant will always tell you the truth. With my CEO of the company, we have that kind of relationship.
What you're looking for, really, somebody you can trust, someone that's hardworking, someone's got imagination. David was never afraid of me. He was straight as a die, honest. He was fantastic communicating with his staff. And every person at Old Trafford recognized that those qualities. He did his best to get the solutions to my everyday whims. So someone we could be, I want floodlights in that pitch and I want a medical center built. And then of course he's saying, you know, calm down, you know. And I would then say, oh, you've got accountant's head on today, haven't you? But there was a respect.
Listening to these huge figures from a wide variety of industries, it's apparent that no leader has a monopoly on the truth. As your career progresses, gather people around you who you trust to tell you the truth.